He has my eyes. Blue on the outside, greenish blue in the middle, with flecks of brown and gold throughout. It looks like we cloned my eyeballs. But he doesn't see red or green the way that I do. My firstborn son is a genetic anomaly. He's colorblind. He scans people's faces for emotions to help regulate. He knows how to make people comfortable as if it's his profession. My secondborn is a lefty who came out of the womb sensitive to sound, touch, music, and emotional intensity. He sits the way his father and his grandfather and his uncle sat, with one leg crossed over the other at the ankle. He was born understanding perspective. He draws in a sketchbook all of the time. He sometimes makes people uncomfortable because he empathizes with everyone, and he shows you emotions that you didn't even know you were feeling. There are so many things I don't understand. What happens inside of black holes, the act of doing tequila shots, the music of Kanye West. But I understand my son's similarities and differences the way only a scientist mama can. I understand DNA. Inside every single cell of our bodies, there's a core called the nucleus, and inside of that core is DNA. DNA is a kind of code, and amino acids are the output of that code, and they determine your genetic makeup. Genes are sections of DNA that mean something. They direct the proteins of your cells to make things. Make his eyes like this. Make his heart like this. Make his soul like this. When I look at myself, at my sons, at you, what I see is DNA. I mean, sure, there are parts of you that are just you, but is there any part of us that's really just us? This scientist says, no. We are the expression of DNA combining and recombining itself over millions of years. We are the result of mutations, which can be spontaneous or encouraged by environmental factors. These mutations provide the variety of creation that is our existence. When a sperm and an egg meet, they bring together groupings of DNA, one set from the sperm and one set from the egg. Within hours, that DNA has combined to make a person. So if you make love at bedtime and a sperm and an egg meet, by the time you wake up in the morning, there's a human being growing inside of your body. Well, if you're the woman. Everything is pretty much determined. Eye color, propensity to have panic attacks or not, an ability to understand the music of Kanye West, and the ability to feel what others are feeling inside of you as if you're feeling it for yourself. This combination and recombination of DNA is happening all of the time, all over the world, like right now, again and again, like now. And again, now. Every combination of cells is a miracle waiting to happen, thanks to DNA, replication, and possibility. More of you and different of you, better than you and made of you. It's intricate and elegant, and it's simple and inevitable. DNA is so extremely long that it has to be smooshed up really, really tight to fit into the nucleus of each cell. It coils up into what's called a double helix, and if you uncoil it, it basically looks like a ladder. Each ladder of DNA is a representation of our existence. Reaching for more, wondering what's next, and being open to the possibility of falling or continuing to climb. When I look at my sons, when I stare into their eyes, I get to see their souls because they are made up of the ladder of existence which DNA makes possible. Set in motion, always evolving, never ending, and forever beautiful. Thank you, DNA. I love you. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel.